Plateau pressure is defined as the amount of pressure needed to keep the lungs inflated in the absence of airflow. It can be measured during mechanical ventilation by applying an inspiratory hold or occluding the exhalation port at in-inspiration for a half a second to 2 seconds. We created this video to provide an overview of plateau pressure and discuss how it should be monitored in patients who are on the ventilator. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, plateau pressure is the pressure in the lungs during mechanical ventilation that can be measured by performing an inspiratory pause at the end of inspiration. It is also known as peak alveolar pressure and is the best bedside clinical reflection of transpulmonary pressure. An accurate plateau pressure cannot be measured while a patient is breathing. Therefore, sedation may be required to obtain a plateau pressure measurement if the patient has an active respiratory drive. That is because it can temporarily suppress the patient's drive to breathe so that plateau pressure can be obtained during a pause at end inspiration. So you may be wondering, why is plateau pressure important? Plateau pressure is important because it can help determine the amount of pressure needed to keep the lungs inflated in the absence of airflow. It serves as an excellent bedside assessment of the ventilation pressure level that could potentially be dangerous to the patient's lungs. This is essential because too much pressure can lead to barrel trauma and overdistension. However, limiting the plateau pressure reduces the risk of ventilator-induced lung injuries. Therefore, lower plateau pressures usually result in better patient outcomes. Now let's talk about the plateau pressure normal values. The normal value for plateau pressure is less than 30 centimeters of water pressure. However, the normal range for plateau pressure is between 25 and 30. If the plateau pressure exceeds 30, it increases the risk of barrel trauma and ventilator-induced lung injuries. So now let's discuss what causes an increased plateau pressure. Increased plateau pressures can result from conditions that cause lung stiffness and decreased lung compliance. Some examples include pulmonary fibrosis and ARDS. Pulmonary fibrosis is a condition characterized by the scarring of lung tissue, which makes it difficult for the lungs to expand. ARDS is a serious lung condition characterized by fluid in the alveoli. It results in refractory hypoxemia, decreased lung compliance, and severe oxygen insufficiency. Now we need to discuss how to measure plateau pressure on the ventilator. In order to measure plateau pressure, the practitioner who is operating the machine must use the inspiratory pause control after a breath has been delivered but before exhalation. This inspiratory hold should last briefly, usually in the range from half a second to 2 seconds. This allows enough time for the measurement to be obtained. The ventilator uses an internal manometer to measure the plateau pressure. Then the reading is displayed on the screen where it can be interpreted by respiratory therapists and other medical professionals. The next topic that I should mention is how to calculate plateau pressure. Again, plateau pressure can be measured by performing an inspiratory hold on the mechanical ventilator. However, it can also be calculated using the following formula. Plateau pressure is equal to the tidal volume divided by static compliance plus the PEEP. This means that you must know the patient's exhaled tidal volume, static compliance, and level of PEEP in order to calculate their plateau pressure. For example, let's say a patient has the following: a tidal volume of 500, static compliance of 22, and a PEEP of 5. To calculate the plateau pressure, you can simply plug the numbers into the formula, which would look like this. Plateau pressure is equal to 500 divided by 22 plus 5. When you calculate it out, it equals 27.7 centimeters of water pressure. As you can see, the formula for calculating plateau pressure is relatively simple. However, it is important to note that the numbers must be correct in order for the calculation to be accurate. Another topic that we should mention is peak pressure. How are peak pressure and plateau pressure related? Well, peak pressure or peak inspiratory pressure is the highest pressure that occurs in the lungs during the inspiratory phase of breathing. It represents the amount of pressure needed to overcome airway resistance and chest wall compliance in order to deliver a breath. Plateau pressure, on the other hand, is the pressure in the lungs in the absence of airflow. As previously mentioned, it is measured by performing an inspiratory pause at end inspiration. The peak pressure is reached during inspiration, but then the pressure decreases to the plateau pressure during the inspiratory hold. Therefore, the plateau pressure should always be lower than the peak pressure during volume-controlled ventilation. That is because airway resistance affects the peak pressure as air flows through the lungs. However, the plateau pressure can exceed the peak pressure in pressure-regulated ventilator modes if the patient's inspiratory efforts generate larger tidal volumes and significantly negative pleural pressures. Conditions that cause an increased airway resistance, such as bronchoconstriction, will result in higher peak pressures. Plateau pressure, on the other hand, is not affected by airway resistance since it is measured during a period of no airflow. So to give a quick recap, here are some rules of thumb to remember. Peak pressure is the pressure generated by the ventilator that is required to overcome airway and alveolar resistance. Plateau pressure is the pressure in the lungs after a tidal volume breath has been delivered. A normal plateau pressure with an increased peak pressure indicates an increased airway resistance. On the other hand, an increased plateau pressure and an increased peak pressure indicates that the patient has an issue with lung compliance. Another topic that I should briefly mention is driving pressure. Driving pressure in mechanical ventilation is measured by subtracting the positive end expiratory pressure from the plateau pressure. In other words, the driving pressure is equal to the plateau pressure minus the peak. It is often considered to be the amount of energy that is applied to the lungs. Therefore, the higher the driving pressure, the higher the amount of energy that is being applied to the lungs. This also means that the patient is at a higher risk of developing a ventilator-induced lung injury. Therefore, in order to minimize this risk, the driving pressure should be kept below 15 centimeters of water pressure. This can be achieved by using a lower tidal volume with proper levels of PEEP. Another common question I get is, what is an inspiratory pause in mechanical ventilation? As previously mentioned, an inspiratory pause is a control mechanism on the ventilator that allows practitioners to measure a patient's plateau pressure. Although rarely used for therapeutic purposes, an inspiratory pause maneuver may also be used for the following clinical purposes: to improve the distribution of inspired air, to improve the PaO2, to improve the delivery of inhaled bronchodilators, and to ensure full inspiration during a chest radiograph. However, the most common reason for performing an inspiratory pause, of course, is to measure the plateau pressure, which we've thoroughly discussed throughout this video. However, if the end inspiratory pause maneuver is performed too frequently, it can lead to patient ventilator asynchrony. This is especially true in patients who are breathing spontaneously. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.